Good morning, students. Once more, we are in the online teaching platform. It's already day 390, almost day 390 since COVID pandemic has been declared by World Health Organization. And we are almost at the start of second wave of COVID-19 in India. And that's why we want you all to be safe. And that's why we are now once again in online teaching lectures. So let's start with today's topic. Today we'll be talking about entomology. Yes. So entomology is a very important part as far as all the communicable diseases are considered, since many of the communicable diseases, they are transmitted through the medium of insects. Okay. So what is entomology? As you can see in the pictures, we have these three most important animals. Yes, insects are also known as animals because they are part of kingdom Animalia. Okay. So all these animals, they cause lot of human diseases. Okay. As you can see, we have a common house fly, we have a mosquito, and we have the head lice, okay, in the pictures. So these animals or these insects and a number of other insects are part of the medical entomology. Okay. If we can measure how many number of deaths, human deaths, are due to the effect by any animal, then which animal stands first in the list? It is the mosquito. Okay. It is not shark, it is not dog, it is not lion, it is not bull, it is not jackal, it is not crocodile, it is the mosquito. Mosquito causes more number of deaths in the human beings than all other animal bite deaths or animal related deaths combined together. Okay. Yes. So let's start with the basic of entomology. Entomology is nothing but study of arthropods of medical importance. Okay. Arthropods. What are arthropods? These are classified into class Insecta, Arachnida, and Crustacea. Class Insecta, we have mosquitoes, flies, human lice, fleas, and radovid bugs. Class Arachnida, we have ticks and mites. And class Crustacea, we have cyclopes, which is found in the water. Okay. Mosquitoes are two types, anopheles and pulicines. Flies, we have house flies, sand fly, tsetse fly, and black flies. Human lice, we have head and body lice and crab lice. And fleas, we have rat flea, sand flea, and radovid bugs. Class Arachnida, we have ticks in the form of hard ticks and soft ticks, mites in the form of leptothrombidium and thrombiculite mites and itch mites. In class Crustacea, we have cyclops. What are the distinctive characteristics of these arthropods of medical importance? Okay, so as you all must have remembered from your high school days, that when they taught you about different insects, they taught you regarding how we can identify them, how we can classify them depending on their different body parts. Okay. So we have body divisions. In class Insecta, they have head, thorax, and abdomen. In class Arachnida, they have cephalothorax and abdomen. Okay. So there is no any distinctive differentiation between head and thorax. So that's why we call it as cephalothorax and abdomen. And there is even no distinction between cephalothorax and abdomen in some cases, in case of Arachnida. In Crustacea, we have cephalothorax and abdomen different. Legs, Insecta, they have three pairs of legs. Arachnida, they have four pairs of legs. And Crustacea, they have five pairs of legs. Antennae in Insecta, they have one pair of antenna, no antennae in Arachnida, and two pairs of antenna in Crustacea or Cyclops. Insects, they might have one or two pairs of links, that is two or four links, and some insects in class Insecta, they are wingless. Arachnida and Crustacea, they don't have wings. Where are found? Insects and Arachnida, they are Insecta and Arachnida, they are found on land, while Crustacea, which is Cyclops, it is found in water. Now, how exactly the disease transmission of arthropod diseases takes place? It can be by direct contact, it can be through mechanical transmission, or it can be through biological transmission. Okay, so remember, there are three types of disease transmission processes: either direct contact, or mechanical, or biological transmission. What is direct contact? Directly transferred, the disease is directly transferred from man to man through close contacts. Okay, so in this case, the scabies and pediculosis. Pediculosis is nothing but the head lice. Okay, so scabies and pediculosis are the causative agent of the disease. Okay, in direct contact type of transmission, the scabies mite, okay, or itch mite, it itself causes the disease. Okay, they are not carrying any other disease transmitting agent like bacteria or virus or fungi. Okay, so direct contact, here the insects, they are the direct cause of the disease. In mechanical transmission, the disease causing agent are transmitted mechanically by vectors. Example, diarrhea, dysentery, which is caused due to cholera, typhoid, or other diarrhea causing viruses. Okay, so this is fecal transmission. What happens is, when these insects like cockroaches and common house fly, they first feed on the fecal matter. If people are following open defecation, if the sanitation is not proper, if there are open drainages, then flies will go and sit on this human fecal matter in this drainage, in the open defecation. And mechanically, the disease causing agent, say for example, typhoid bacteria. The typhoid bacteria will get attached to the proboscis, get attached to the limbs of this fly and cockroaches. And then again, this fly, they come sit on the food which is prepared in our houses, or come and sit on the food which is there on display outside in the hotels. Okay, and when humans, susceptible humans, they consume this food material, they get infected with this disease-causing agent. Okay, so this is mechanical transmission. Now, what is biological transmission? The disease-causing agent, it undergoes developmental changes with or without multiplication in the vector, or in these insects. For example, malaria. Okay, what happens when a mosquito, an Anopheles mosquito, bites a person who is having the disease malaria? What happens is, this malaria parasite gametes, they come through the proboscis, through the blood, they go inside the abdomen of the mosquito. Okay, then that mosquito which has bitten the malaria affected person, the mosquito gets infected with malaria. Okay, the malarial parasite, they develop, undergo cyclical changes in the body of mosquito. They survive, they multiply, they metamorphose in the mosquito, and then again they come in the salivary glands of mosquito. So the next time when this Anopheles mosquito, it bites another susceptible person, that malarial parasite gets inoculated into that person, and then that second person will get malaria. So this is biological transmission. Okay, so remember, the direct contact transmission, where mostly the disease causing agent is the insect itself. Example is scabies and pediculosis, that is head lice. Mechanical transmission, the disease causing agent is just transmitted from one place to another place through the mechanical transmission from the flies, cockroaches, etc. And biological transmission, disease causing agent, the parasite, the bacteria, or the virus gets inoculated, infects the mosquito, or infects the insect, and then that insect, when bites another person, when comes in contact with another person, that susceptible host gets infected from that disease. Okay, yes. So what are the types of biological transmission? We have propagative, cyclodevelopmental, and cyclopropagative type of transmission. Okay, propagative type of transmission, there is only multiplication of disease causing agent, and there are no any cyclical changes. The best example is plague bacilli in rat flea. Okay, so rat flea causes rat flea first bites the rats which are affected with the plague bacilli, or other small mammals which are affected with plague bacilli, and then this rat flea gets infected with this plague bacilli, and this plague bacilli only multiply in this rat flea. And after multiplication, what happens is when this rat flea go and bite another animal, go and bite human beings, susceptible human beings, they these plague bacilli are inoculated into those human beings and they get the disease plague. Okay, this is propagative. So remember PP, that is propagative plague. Okay, cyclodevelopmental. So this is only the cyclical changes of the disease causing agent happen in the insect. There is no multiplication. Okay, so cyclodevelopmental. So one, we have propagative, where there is only multiplication, no development. Cyclodevelopmental, we have only development or only cyclical changes, morphological changes in the number of in the insect causing agent, in the disease causing agent, and no multiplication. Okay, that is cyclodevelopmental. The best example is filarial parasite in Culex mosquito. So the number of filarial parasites in the Culex mosquito, they remain the same, but there is a change in the morphology of the filarial parasite. So that from primitive life cycle point, they will advance into the next stage in their life cycle, the filarial parasites. Okay, so this is cyclodevelopmental, can be remembered as CDF. Okay, so propagative PP, propagative plague, cyclodevelopmental filaria, and cyclopropagative, the best example is malaria, where both multiplication and cyclical changes, they occur in the insect body. Okay, so cyclopropagative, the both multiplication and cyclical changes, they happen in the Anopheles mosquito in case of malaria. So remember CPM. Okay, so the best way to remember is PP, propagative plague, CDF, cyclodevelopmental filaria, and CPM, that is cyclopropagative malarial parasite. Now some definitions regarding the entomology. Now, what is vector? Vector is the one which transmits infection by inoculation into or through the skin or mucous membrane by biting or by deposition of infective materials on the skin or on food or any other objects which cause the disease in the susceptible host. Okay, so vector is any insect which will transmit the disease causing agent from one point to another point, from one source or one reservoir of infection to the susceptible host, is nothing but vector. So what is extrinsic incubation period? The period of time necessary for the development of the disease agent in the arthropod host. Okay, remember extrinsic incubation period and intrinsic incubation period. Intrinsic incubation period is the incubation period in human beings. Extrinsic incubation period is the incubation period in the arthropod host. So what is definitive host? The host in which the sexual cycle of the agent takes place. Okay, so male and female gametes of the parasite will come in that host first, and then the actual sexual cycle, that means the joining of male and female gamete to give rise to zygote, and the adult or the primitive parasite form will take place in this definitive host. Intermediate host is the host in which the asexual cycle of the agent occurs. It is called intermediate host. So what is known as infestation? The lodgement or the development and reproduction of arthropods on the surface of the body or in the clothing, okay, is known as infestation. The best example is scabies or head lice. Okay, head lice, the infestation of human hairs with head lice is known as pediculosis. Okay, or the lodgement and development and reproduction of the arthropods in on the surface of the body or the clothing is known as infestation. So that's all regarding the introduction to the entomology. So remember what are the different types of classification of the insects, then what are the distinctive characteristics of arthropods, what is the difference between direct, mechanical, and biological transmission, and what are the three types of biological transmission: propagative, cyclodevelopmental, and cyclopropagative. All these are short answer questions, and these are the most important as far as your entrance examinations are considered. They will ask you what type of transmission, biological transmission, plague bacilli takes place in rat flea. So the answer will be propagative. What type of transmission the filarial parasite will take place in Culex mosquito? The answer will be cyclodevelopmental, and cyclopropagative is malarial parasite in Anopheles mosquito. So remember, PP is propagative plague, CDF is cyclodevelopmental filarial parasite, and CPM is cyclopropagative in malarial parasite. Okay. Yes. So that's all regarding today's topic. Take care and please stay safe and stay at home.